3 this Friday morning. So good to have you with us. 515-51. Wonderful text.
Thanks coming in. So keep them coming in. Thank you for that.
Jenny Healy, good morning to you.
Good morning, Ryan. How are you?
Are you well?
I've never been busier, and thanks to yourself and the late night, and of course Gary Farming, thank you for Joel sharing his story and educating so many about how we need to learn our sign language and embrace our country's official language. So I work as a sign teacher, so it's been a busy week.
I'm delighted. I noticed you on Instagram because you tagged me on one of your things saying that you're going to be doing a sign language course for people by way of introduction. And I thought, This is exactly what Callum was trying to achieve through his appearance on the late night, but also his dad came here first, and then we chatted about it all. And that interview was very, I found it very moving at a personal and a professional level. Did you see it as it was happening?
I did, Ryan, and everywhere I've been this week, you know, the families that I work with that have deaf children, the schools that I'm going into, the companies that I'm on Zoom calls to, every single person has just been talking about the late or heard Andrew's interview himself. And they achieved just that, the reaction from people. So I have an Instagram page called Mind with Jenny where I just put up kind of sign language videos to the general public and my TY students to keep learning sign language and, you know, how to introduce yourself. And I'm so moved by the hearing family story, I was just like them every week in Wicklow, my first, so I'm doing sign class on Saturday, so I just put up a post after the late day, you know, put on a Zoom class for everyone and anyone, you know, if you were inspired by this story and want to learn sign language, you know, give me a message and the reaction was just
I mean, 50 people on the Zoom call last night. We actually had to have them trained with our daughter, Cass.
Oh, good. Yeah, great kid.
What an example he is, you know, how to support a deaf sibling, you know, how effortlessly cool he was signing and speaking at the same time. We actually had his art school teacher or that course on the Zoom call as well. So it was brilliant. And we actually recorded a short clip at the end. Just to say hello to him, and we're learning ourselves. I just want to touch with Andrew, you know, about the importance of supporting the whole speaking opportunity for the story and, you know, letting so many people in, opening people's eyes to why so many people need to learn and embrace this language, truly has inspired so many. And that's not just for myself, that farmers and teachers across the country have just been inundated with emails. What can we do? How can we learn? How can we support?
I'm so happy and heartened to hear this because it's taking the ISL story a little step further, a small step, but I hope an important step. And when you did a Zoom class this week, did you get good recruitment for it?
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm running a course in June, like a beginner course, and thankfully so many people on the side, like, you know, that time is up. But for anyone listening across the country, we have so many services, you know, the deaf clubs and associations, the Irish Deaf Society, the Irish Deaf Society. The best way to learn a foreign language is to get out there and meet deaf people. They're the native signers. That's how I would learn the language when I studied in the Centre for Deaf Studies in Trinity College Dublin. And you'll see for yourself how much it means to a deaf member to see someone outside of the community taking the time out to learn about their culture, to learn about their language, and making an effort to convert with them.
One of the most beautiful sounds in the world is a baby's first mama, daddy, gurgle of a word. If a non-verbal child, who will never be verbal, is deaf, what is the equivalent for a parent with that baby?
Yeah, so we have their first sign, and that's probably, to be honest, one of my favorite parts of the job. We have something called the ISL home tuition scheme, which is covered by the Department of Education, where you go in and meet a family that has a deaf child and teach the whole family sign language every week. And it's just, you make such bonds and connections with those families, because 90% of deaf children worldwide, they're born to hear your parents. So, you know, that's the first time they're learning sign language, which is a whole new world to them. And it's been fantastic. I've been there times in the house prior to COVID where you see the first sign. At the moment, it's all over Zoom. The last few years, so I've seen WhatsApp. So it's the exact same thing. The first time might be mama or dada or bird or cat. A few things that actually sign light for the very first time. Because
deaf children are so visual. It's a great way for getting a deaf baby's attention, switching on and off the lights, because wherever they are sitting on the floor, and we're going to turn around to see where their parent is and do the sign for light. So, there's been a couple, but more milk is usually a popular one as well.
And their signing is with their little hands.
They're signing with their little hands. So we have what we call kind of baby sign language. I mean, sign for brother and father, a little bit more context, so they'll sign mom and dad on their cheek. And just like babies, when they don't say mom and dad, you know, particularly perfect when they're younger, and then as they grow, they learn how to do the sign properly. But it's the exact same with that excitement, and I guess for a lot of families, it is a new chapter, and it's a journey that you weren't expecting when you find out your child is deaf or hard of hearing. And I guess when you see them communicating sign back for the first time, it's just like, you've got this, you know, it's just a language, that's the only difference. And so many people that learn it are like, wow, I can't get over how much I'm enjoying it. And, I'm picking it up so much quicker because I'm doing this now since 2015, and I just love my job,
I love the language. I can sense that, and I love your passion. But why did you, and it sounds like a strange way of asking this, but why did you bother?
I'm glad you've asked this, because especially for young listeners listening in, there's a course in Trinity College Dublin called the Centre for Deaf Studies, and it's a four-year degree programme. That is open to everyone and anyone. A lot of the lecturers in Trinity and the Centre for Deaf Studies are deaf, so really high-end intellectuals with PhDs under their belt. Some of the students are deaf or hard of hearing or COSA, so children and deaf adults. But then there's people just like me that have no link to the deaf community. I didn't have a deaf family member or friend. I grew up, I guess, in RC news and the signing, and I'm fascinated by the language. I definitely wanted to go into a career working with children, and this is a new course in Trinity, and I just got lucky, I got into the course, and I guess I had a very different experience than my other time in college, because Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, there's no talking, you have to use sign language, because if you're a hearing person going into that course, you're entering the deaf world and the deaf community, and it's up to you to pick up sign language as quick as possible so you can communicate with your peers and lecturers. So you finish that 4-year degree, fluent in sign language. So that's where interpreters and sign language teachers would train, where we're all across Ireland. So I cannot recommend it enough. That's why the TY courses I love that I do, because I just want to get out there and, tell other younger people about this course and this whole community that we have on the island, that it's open to anyone with even interest in it. And you won't regret it. You make friends for life. It's a small course. It's only about 20-25 per course. It's a job that I've just been very lucky to get into, because it's something I just love getting up every day to do.
And do you hear differently to me? I mean, if you spend your day signing, and then at the end of the day you're back into the world of hearing. Do you have a more heightened sense of hearing?
I definitely know that in college, if you go 9 to 5 or you're signing all day at lunchtime, like a break. There's deaf people in your course, you have to keep signing. It would be rude to be talking. You know how to converse in ISL, but that's why you know it, you use it. So you'd be doing that all day, and then I get on the dark back, hold your grey zones, and it'd be the first time I'm hearing noise during the day, and it could be the first time I'm actually, see if I'm in the dark and start speaking. So that's definitely it to get used to, but I kind of work with families, and I'm family now, like I go to family where the parents might be deaf or grandparents might be deaf, and I mean not much work to do there, like every young boy in Wexford, and he's got deaf parents, and it's just extraordinary to see them. He's only four and being the level of ISL, and I just really dare to kind of break the gap when you start school and doing games, just having another person in his life to communicate through ISL, because I think what the year is on the cash is so beautifully, we need children in this country to know we have so many deaf people and so many people with hearing people working in this community, you know, and there's so many jobs that you can do, and it's a job in demand, and we need more interpreters and we need more teachers. Like I'm based in Dublin, and I work in Dublin with Wicklow Wexford. I mean, the last year a lot of the home tutoring classes have been approved to go online, which has been brilliant. And for the first time, I've been able to take on families and do a goal, and it feels great. But I know myself and other sign language teachers in Mayo, of course, and other parts of Dublin. And, you know, that has been actually really beneficial because we're able to reach families that vitally need to learn this language.
Did you get a lot of people that sign up for your free Zoom who had never intended to learn one bit of ISL or never thought it would be in their zone at all?
Yeah, I had a mix. I mean, the stories you can see online today. Some people are like, I work in a bank and I actually get people that come in and I always wanted to learn. And I saw all of this, like, I saw the late, like, right now is the time to do it. That when they come in, next week on Monday morning, I'm able to start recording. And I'm able to ask how you do it. And so there was a lot of people that had personal reasons, but then there were so many people. And that's what the late did. You know, you don't need to know a deaf person or working with a deaf person. Just learn it. Just show that solidarity with the deaf community. And we will create a country that is, you know, where children can go into the shop, they can go to, you know, wherever they are during the day, they can talk into people. Because I completely agree with what Andrew here is saying. I was asking this morning when I sent them that video of the Zoom call last night, that we do need to get it as part of our curriculum. If you go to other countries, now, children are learning sign language, which is part of their curriculum. They know about the deaf community. They know how to convert with deaf people. And not just schools. I mean, companies have been fantastic. Like, I work for companies usually that will have deaf employees and, you know, hearing staff once a week. They're doing a Zoom coffee call. Solace is an example there for their education organization. The last year, they've been learning sign language to converse with their deaf employees. But particularly in the last week, there are companies that have no deaf employees that are just like, let's do this, let's sign up, let's make our work environment this inclusive place that if you do have a deaf person wanting to apply for a job in this company, we're ready to go. They don't need to explain that they use ISL as their first language. They don't need to explain about their community and culture because that company has already been upskilled about it.
Yeah, okay, you're some woman, Jenny, I have to say, because your passion for the subject is tremendous. You're a great advocate for deaf studies and for ISL. So thank you for spreading the love this morning. Great to talk to you.
Thank you, Ryan.
See you soon. Thank you very much, Jenny Healy, joining us. And as she said, her Instagram for sure is called Sign with Jenny, and that'll give you lead you to where you need to go in terms of signing up. But you mentioned different groups there as well, like the Irish Deaf Society and Chimes, and you know, there's if you want to, it's there. If you want to take the opportunity, grab it at 40 minutes to 10.